Happy holidays, everybody. What is going on? Today, we're going to be talking all about the holidays and hair systems and all of the things that this is entailing. Now, if you are thinking about getting a hair system or you currently got one this year, you are probably thinking about some stuff that you haven't thought about before. You're thinking about friends, you're thinking about family, people you haven't seen, traveling, all of that kind of stuff. And how does that relate to your hair system? What are people gonna think? What are people gonna do? How do I handle all these situations? There's a lot of stuff to consider. This video right here, I want to be a primer for you to be ready. Go out there, have a great holiday season, whether you're spending it alone or with family or anything like that. So, talking about the holidays, there are always a lot of stress, a lot of financial stress, a lot of stress of seeing old friends, seeing family, getting everything done in this year on top of it with, you know, the current world situation, you know, masks up. It's just a different time. There's a lot of stress, but this year there's a lot of particular stress. Now, if you decided to get a hair system this year, you're probably facing a lot of situations that you've never faced before in your life. Situations like, hey, how do I talk with people who I haven't seen in over the past year, who don't know about my hair system, who don't know what this is, who are going to be seeing me and they're going to obviously notice a difference. How do you handle that? How do you handle the travel? How do you handle all the things that are come up? So let's just talk about them one by one. First, how do you handle those conversations with people who have not seen you with a hair system before and the things that they might think? So first up, you know, your first interaction with people that you haven't seen in the past year, they're obviously going to know a difference unless, you know, you did this early in your hair loss journey and things like this. Now, if you had a lot of hair, but this is just a gradual change for you, it's something small. You know, if you don't feel confident with telling them the truth, you could probably get away with telling them, you know, you're taking Rogaine or finasteride, or you know, you found a medication that's helping you. You could go with this. But if you're a little bit more advanced, or you want to be honest, you want to be vulnerable, I think it's easy to word vomit when, you know, we first see someone and they're like, oh my God, you look so different, and trying to explain it in that moment. I think that's the wrong moment to explain why you look different, or what it is that you're doing. You want to take that at a opportune moment, right? So if you open up the door and you see family and they're like, oh my God, you look so different, you look great, what happened? I would choose to defer and say, oh my gosh, got a great story to tell you of how I completely changed my look. And they'll be like, what did you get, you know, Rogaine, or did you like, what happened? How did you do this? You got to tell us. Be like, you know, we'll talk about it over dinner when we're all sitting and we're all relaxed and we have a drink in us. Now, the reason for this right here is it kind of gives you time to first get comfortable with them again, start, you know, the story, start the conversation. And then over dinner, as people are more relaxed, you can actually get some quality time, explain yourself, explain why you did what you did and how it's positively affected your life. And that itself is probably one of the biggest tips that I have for you when you're talking about the changes that you've made, namely your hair system. If you talk about it and you frame it in a way of like, this is how I've changed my life, this is how it's improved my life and how it's done things for me, it's really, really hard to, even if someone was to make fun of you, it's really, really hard to take someone who's done some action, taken action and gone forward and felt better about a decision that they made. It's hard to make fun of them. You just can't. Like, it's like, oh, well, okay. It's helped you in your professional life. It's helped you get fit. It's helped you eat better. Just because you feel better about yourself, well, shoot, dude, like, more power to you. You know, they might not agree with your decision. They might think it's, you know, you might have the friend or family that's a little bit more of a traditional person or conservative, and they think that's not a manly thing to do. Well, you know, they got to tip their hat when you say like, hey, I've had all this success in my life, or it's done so many things for me. So framing it as part of like, you know, your successes for the year, I think is a big part of it. It's all about the story and the narrative that you weave with people. If you're cautious, if you're very shy about it, people can eat you alive because they sense your shyness. They sense your nervousness in your body language, in your voice, in your tone, in your ability to convey your message. And people will eat you alive. They'll feel your awkwardness around the subject and they'll probably poke and prod it. This is what family and friends do. They poke and they prod in those areas just to test and pressure test us and things like this. So if you come in confident, you come in prepared, knowing that you're framing this as part of your success for the year and how you're moving forward and becoming a better you, you become unshakable. You become a rock. Right? And even better, if you have a friend there to support you, if you're going to, you know, Christmas with your family and you have a partner, definitely help have them have your back. You know, talk with them before and say, hey, this is something that's going to come up. This is something that's going to happen. Please back me up here and show your support. Because that person can act as kind of like the first follower. They can kind of act as someone that can really, really help. So now that we talked a little bit about, you know, how do you deal with those conversations, let's talk about how you deal with criticism around hair systems, right? And this is very, very similar to the last point, but undoubtedly, some of us are going to face people that make fun of us, that don't think it's a good idea, that just like, well, why don't you just shave your head and stuff like that. You know, it's really, really easy to escalate a situation when we're communicating with someone else, when we feel we're being attacked. You know, someone can say something like that and it's very aggressive and it's actually inappropriate and it's rude and it's disrespectful. But if we treat it as rude, disrespectful, out of place, and return that with aggressive behavior in ourselves, we're actually making the situation worse. Now, this is something that goes doubly true for anything in life, your relationships with partners, family, anything. Anytime you try to match someone's energy and their aggressiveness and either match it or one up it, you are going to have a really rough time. If you want to handle it through aggression and through combativeness, whatever, that's you. But I am telling you, the way to handle these situations and to win is to actually remain stoic. So if someone is making fun of you, someone's criticizing you, they do the whole, oh, why don't you shave your head, or, oh man, isn't that what girls do, or something like that. Listen, all you got to do, look them in the eyes, smile at them, go, yeah, you know, you may think that, but this has really done some amazing things for me. And actually, it's not as uncommon as you think. Here's the thing. These hair systems, they look so good now that I bet you probably at least 10 people that you know in real life have these hair systems. You just don't know it. But I was brave enough to tell you, and I'd appreciate it if you either gave me some support or just kept quiet about it. And what that does is it deflates the situation and it says like, hey, this is more normal than you think it is. I know more about this than you do. And if you're not going to support me, then I really don't want to hear what you have to think. And what that is it's a very grounded response. It's a very rooted response that it makes it very hard for someone to attack you. And if they come back, you just do the same thing. You know, you smile at them and, you know, you basically turn their insult or their aggressiveness back on them, as if you're almost amused by their somehow interest in your life, right? You know, if they're attacking you in your decisions, you just smile at them, look at them, give them a little chuckle and be like, oh man, well, thank you for being really interested in my life. But this is a choice that I've made and it's really helping me for the better. But thank you. Thank you for your concern. And by the way, how's your family? Right? You know, you constantly just mirror their energy, but when you actually absorb their energy, treat it with love and send it right back to them and help them understand that their criticism, their critiques, their insults, their whatever, they can't actually hurt you. And this is the beautiful thing about becoming a better man, personally developing as a man, is once you realize you're doing these things for yourself, to become a better man, to show up more and more every day, those criticisms, those critiques, things like that, they don't hold any weight because you don't care what someone thinks of you. That really doesn't have an impact on your life. Even friends and family that are close have very, very little impact on our life unless we give it to them. So don't give that power to someone. Keep it internal. That's yours. All right, let's move on to some of the other topics. Namely, what about handling the actual hair system on holidays, right? So it's not uncommon to be gone for a week, 2 weeks away from the masses, away from your, you know, your, if you're using a salon, how do you handle doing this yourself? How do you handle fixing maintenances or, you know, fixing hairlines and things like that? How do you handle all these things? Well, guys, if you have gone and you've done the research, you've been watching this channel and you've been experimenting with doing reinstalls, reapplications yourself, that's great. And I commend you because that takes away a lot of the stress. But if you have not, here's one of the two things you can do. Number one, if you are using someone to reinstall your hair systems or reapply, you can do two things. First, you can get it reinstalled right before you leave and try to make it last about 2 weeks, which you can do. Just try to be mindful of how much you sweat. That's really the biggest kicker, sweat and sleep. So if you're sleeping, don't sleep on the back of your hair system, sleep on your stomach, something like that. Have your silk pillow. That way it's not causing a lot of friction and it's not putting a lot of tension on the adhesive. Also, try to not engage in a lot of sweat inducing activities, lay off the exercise, things like that, right? That's gonna kill the bond time. So you can either get it reinstalled right before, or you can find someone in your local area that is gonna be able to provide those services for you. You can check out, you know, like a local hair club, the brand hair club, ask if they can do a reinstall during that time period. That might be possible. You can always call up local providers. Generally, if you're near any metro area, there are gonna be people. However, what I would do is I would book an appointment sooner than later. I know that it's the holidays right now, but if you're thinking about needing it towards the end of vacation, if you're thinking about needing it, go get it done now, because you know, the holiday seasons, everyone wants to look their best. Everyone gets haircuts. Everyone does this. The schedules book up. So definitely make sure you take care of this sooner than later. Now, if you are willing to try and learn this stuff yourself, now is the time to watch videos. Try it before you go on vacation. Now, this is my personal best way, I think, to learn how to do maintenance yourself. What I would do is I would book an appointment. If you've never done it before, I would book an appointment for a reinstall with whoever you use for, say, tomorrow, right? And then today, I would actually try to do it myself. Now, the reason that I do this is because it allows me to experiment and try to do it without having serious repercussions. You know, if for some reason I can't get it right and I can't do it today, I can have it reinstalled tomorrow by a professional and it's like, you know, life is normal. Might have to wear a hat tomorrow until my appointment, but anything like that, it's okay. You can get through it until the proper time. But you're going to want to start learning this stuff sooner than later. Now, you should be able to make it through most of the holidays without having to do a full install, but what you might have to do is work on your hairline depending on how much you sweat, your adhesive, how long bond times stick and hold, right? So that being said, I would start watching some videos about how to fix your hairline. There's easy ways to basically use a mixture of solvents, cotton balls, and then basically your adhesive of choice to reapply your frontal hair system hairline. Now, that is not the hardest thing in the world to do. You know, you're gonna have to be working over your head like this right here, but it's really not that bad as like putting on a whole hair system for the first time. That can be pretty daunting and pretty tough, but just pulling up the front of your system, cleaning it, and actually reapplying a layer of adhesive or tape, not that hard whatsoever. All you've got to do is take some solvent, lift it up, clean the base of the unit, right? So if there's some adhesive on it, if it's liquid adhesive, get some cotton balls with some solvent, wipe it down. If not, if it's just tape, take it off, you know, actually use some solvent to get underneath the tape and then start peeling it off, clean the base, and then reapply the liquid or the tape to your scalp. Doesn't have to be a perfect frontal hairline, as in like you have the perfect front line. Just put some down, you're good to go. That's all you gotta do. Now, the other thing that you can do when you are on vacation, but you don't have to worry about all this stuff, this is the most low maintenance way. Guys, go with a more conservative hairstyle. And what I mean by that is cover the front hairline. Cover the front hairline. And you should be good to go. You're not gonna really have to worry about it. It's not gonna be flying off of your head within 2 weeks, generally speaking. You might have some lifts, but in 2 weeks, not a big deal. Ultimately, another strategy for you is wear a hat most of the time. You know, maybe Christmas dinner or something like that. You show up and you look good, you're in your sweater, you know, you have your hair done and stuff like that. But after that, just wear a hat. You know, so these are some low maintenance ways that you can go about having your hair system, not having to worry about it, not having to worry and stress. So I think that this right here is a good primer and will get you going on the right foot as you're thinking about this holiday season. Don't get too stressed about talking with your friends and family about a decision that you've recently made in your life, such as wearing a hair system. I think you're gonna find that they're gonna be a lot more supportive than you think that they're gonna be. As long as you approach it with being confident, as long as you approach it with being grounded and rooted and ready to explain how it's made you more successful in your life and helping you become a better man. Guys, I hope you have a great holiday season. Even though we're socially distanced for most of us during this time period, we can still have a great holiday season. We can still get in the spirit and we can have a great time. Take care.